haven't had been answering, and then the emails keep pouring in, and I've been trying to keep track of that.
The other day when we sat down, you said, you know, I just don't get it.
You know, I still don't get it.
Some have critiqued a review and even called it pathetic.
But to me, it's interesting.
The Eat Beat started at the Herald, but now she writes here in her own office at her house. And since going viral, you would think the fame would get to her, but Marilyn hasn't changed one bit.
I don't get terribly excited, and I don't get terribly sad. I'm sort of level, I think.
She says she won't clear her schedule for too many interviews. All this commotion hasn't made time for her weekly grocery store trip.
You're just a busy woman.
Yeah, the phone has been ringing constantly.
Next on the list is a review of one of New York's finer restaurants.
To go to a restaurant with, you know, a nice setting, maybe some music and nice food. I'd like to go to a restaurant like Sanders.
Sounds like she's looking for a restaurant that's similar to the Olive Garden. Her thoughts about an appearance on the Jay Leno show are still a little bit foggy.
With Jay? I don't know. I don't like the way he combs his hair, so maybe I wouldn't.
Maybe Mr. Leno could convince her otherwise. Reporting in Grand Forks, I'm Melanie Orlins.
And I still don't get it.
Marilyn also appeared on The Early Show.